Todoist have added a rather attractive calendar experience, and in today's video I wanted to share some of the best ways that you can use Calendar to your advantage and really maximize it. Now, Todoist Calendar is a premium feature, but if you want a deal on Todoist, find it linked below. Now, before we begin, I had a very interesting chat with Amir, who's the founder of Todoist, that explores their plans for the future of Todoist, even into the Apple intelligence side of stuff. So if you're interested in that, you'll find it linked below, and you'll join our newsletter, which naturally will give you some great insights on tools and resources for the future. Let's take a look at the new Todoist calendar. Now, the great thing is Todoist calendar is rolled out to the today and upcoming area. It was available in projects. I'll show you that as well today, don't worry. But this experience is so much better for managing your calendar in one location. So here we are with Todoist calendar. And the first thing I want to show you is the today area. The today area is really nice. There's two things you probably haven't noticed on the top already. There's an area that shows you all of the tasks you've got to do that are uncompleted and how long they're going to take you. This is just a really nice statistic, and it'll help you to give you an idea of how long your day is going to be. Now, all day events sit at the top. And one of the things I didn't show many people when getting started is you can quickly drag something into this area. This is really helpful if you're looking to take something out of a timed blocked area, but come back to it later. And it's a very helpful technique that I find beneficial. So as you can see, anything that you create can be dragged and extended and moved back if you do want to. This is great for organizing stuff. And once you click into the item, you can see things like due date. But if you click into that, you can see something called for 2 hours 15. This is because everything has a duration now, and everything that has a duration will allow you to time block in your system. If you go over to this one here, it doesn't have a duration, just has today. So anything that doesn't have a duration sits on the top in the all day area. You can see all day Google Calendar events that can be connected through settings. I'll show you that a little bit later if you're just a little bit curious how that connects. But if you want to create any task in your calendar view, you can quickly swipe over it. And the great thing is those times will pre-populate as well. You can add things like priority, like normal, add all the relative stuff and be able to add it to a project that you're working on. So as you can see, I've got a few things here and I can move them about if I want to. Now, what the great thing is if I right click, I can see more details as well, which is going to help me to organize it for later. For example, if I say tomorrow or this weekend, it will move that. But let me show you how that looks. If I want to view tomorrow, it's going to go into upcoming. So as you can see, it had a due date, so naturally it's going to appear here. Now, what's really nice is you may notice that a few things look slightly weird, like this has a little weird border around it. Well, essentially anything that has a future occurrence shows up in your Todoist account, which is perfect for organizing recurring tasks. For example, next week looks slightly structured for me as I'm trying some more systems in terms of organizing how I do things. But you can see there that that's quite nice because I've got a time blocked week. But if you think that's a bit intense, you can turn future recurrence off. When I go to next week, things look pretty slim. But if I open it back up, I can see things there. Now, what's really nice is I can skip to month view as well here, which is great. And that's also great for moving things around. For example, if I wanted to, I could drag things to day view, which is better for zooming out and that focus. Now, inside of the calendar area, I can even prioritize by P1, which helps me just to see all of the most important stuff for the week ahead. And I can naturally narrow down to P4 if I did want to. But this is great if you want to bring in a label and a workspace. And I find this particularly helpful when I'm trying to block out my personal stuff and I can quickly see a work calendar that has a focus on just work. Now, you can also block a label as well, which is helpful, and even an assignee too, if that's something you work with together in the projects area. So this view is really nice. I find it really beneficial to have the Google Calendar events, and they click in, which is great, which means you can click into Google Calendar from there. But let me show you the projects area. Projects are a great way to break down different things that you're doing. So for example, here, I've got all of my priorities and I break things down into sections. But if I go to view, I can see that in calendar mode quite easily. Now, what's nice as well is this is going to help me to plan things that are, you know, not that, I guess, anything that is no date associated is going to help me. So I can pop this open and drag stuff into my systems really easily. So if I have a load of tasks in my project area that have no date, it's going to be really beneficial to use something like this. So that's what I tend to do, is in the board view, trying to keep things so that it's very minimal without any dates, so that I can skip to this view and be a bit more definitive and drag stuff in that are important. Now that dragging in element is really helpful because you can actually do that in the today area. For example, anything that's unscheduled and scheduled will appear inside of this area. One of the things that's on my wish list is that you can scrubble this to inbox, because having an inbox ability to drag in items would be really, really helpful. But as you can see, unscheduled is great for being able to see and making sure that you get things focused on for your day ahead. So going back to this work view, this works as no date. And inside of the upcoming area, this works as overdue, meaning that if you miss anything from the day before, this is how you reorganize them in your system. So overdue and naturally plan, and then inside of there, it's no date. Now you can use the calendar view in inbox. This can be a little bit messy. So for example, if you had no dates, they can be dragged into your system. So I guess in a way, you're sort of bringing that today area and moving it into your system so you can organize any inboxed items. But I would like it to be available in today area, if that makes sense. Now, the final thing that I want to show you is the integration with Google Calendar. It's really easy if you go over to integrations and settings. It's got its own area, I forgot. So you can connect up your Google Calendar, you can resync it, and there's an option down here which allows you to sync tasks into your calendar. So it's sort of two-way, which is helpful. So that's a little bit about how to use the Todoist calendar view, and I hope it was helpful in getting some insights in there. Just one thing to note as well, if you want that interview with me and Amir, then you can find that linked below. So I look forward to helping you optimize your Todoist, and hopefully I can help you in the future too. Cheerio!